After Judas allowed Satan to enter him during the Last Supper, John 13 verse 27. The final temptation of Jesus began. For the next 15 hours, Jesus would face unimaginable suffering, a climactic attempt by Satan to lead him into sin. If Satan succeeded, it would mean the end of hope for humanity. As Jesus took his last breath on the cross, John 19 verse 30, Satan eagerly awaited confirmation of his victory. He knew that if Jesus had remained sinless despite all the suffering, he would rise again as he had promised, John 2 verse 19. Time passed, and with each moment, Satan grew more confident that Christ would not return. The disciples were scattered, Matthew 26 verse 31. Chaos reigned, and the world seemed lost. However, on the third day, Satan's confidence was shattered. The stone that sealed the tomb was rolled away, and Jesus' body was gone, Matthew 28 verses 2-6. At that moment, Satan realized that he had been deceived. He had unknowingly played a part in God's plan to redeem humanity, fulfilling every prophecy and ensuring that mankind could receive the glory they did not deserve, Isaiah 53 verses 10-11. With Jesus' resurrection, humanity was granted freedom from Satan's accusations. Jesus had taken the sins of all humanity onto himself, carrying them to the grave and leaving them there through his resurrection, 1 Peter 2 verse 24. For the first time, mankind was deemed worthy to receive the blessings promised by God. Satan, filled with an unimaginable hatred, recognized that he no longer had the power to accuse redeemed believers before God. Satan's platform to bring charges against humanity was destroyed, Revelation 12 verse 10. However, Satan quickly realized that under the new covenant of grace, while all sinners were offered eternal life through belief in Jesus, John 3 verse 16, not everyone would accept this gift. Those who chose to remain in their sin would still perish, and this was the loophole Satan sought to exploit. They would be rejecting their all-loving Creator, essentially condemning themselves, an outcome Satan eagerly sought. As Christianity grew rapidly, Satan knew he needed to act swiftly. He roamed the earth, seeking out human weaknesses and preying upon them. No longer content with his role as the accuser, a title whose power had diminished, he took on a new identity as the devourer. Over the centuries, Satan found success in deceiving and devouring many souls. However, those who believed in Jesus posed a unique challenge. These believers began to gather in worship and mutual support, forming what they called the church and identifying themselves as Christians. Satan quickly recognized this fellowship as a threat. Though the early church stood strong against his attempts to infiltrate, their resistance weakened over time. Satan eventually gained a significant influence in many congregations, leading people back into the dark world of sin and death. Yet, there were always some who resisted his temptations. It was as if they were divinely protected from Satan's attacks. These believers, known as the elect, seemed to possess a special armor that made them immune to the devil's schemes, frustrating Satan immensely. Satan's grip on humanity was now being challenged by these resilient groups, safeguarded by the sacrifice of Jesus, a sacrifice that Satan himself had played a part in facilitating. Realizing their strength came from Jesus' power, Satan knew he needed to devise a more cunning strategy. But how could he, a single being, contend with the risen Savior, now ascended and backed by the Father and the Holy Spirit? The odds were 3 against 1. To mount any meaningful resistance, Satan needed to form a trinity of his own. He continued sowing evil among humanity, preparing them for the ultimate battle against their Lord and Savior. When the time was ripe and all the pieces were in place, Satan stood on the seashore, eagerly awaiting the climax of his plan to unfold. A terrifying beast emerged from the calm waters, displaying 7 heads and 10 fearsome horns. One of its heads bore a fatal wound that had been healed, a mockery of the wounds Christ received during his crucifixion, Revelation 13 verses 1-3. This beast joined forces with Satan in his battle against God. Empowered by Satan, the beast was given authority over the earthly realm, using its charm and deceptive nature to lead people away from Jesus, even trying to deceive the elect. Matthew 24 verse 24. If successful, Satan would crush the remaining resistance in his dark empire and unite humanity against their creator. This beast, known as the man of lawlessness and the son of destruction, 2 Thessalonians 2 verse 3, became infamous as the Antichrist. Under Satan's influence, the Antichrist succeeded in deceiving many, leading them to worship both the beast and Satan himself. The devil, who had previously worked in the shadows, now reveled in being openly worshipped, feeding his pride that had been drained by Christ. But Satan's unholy trinity was not yet complete. The earth opened up, revealing a second beast with two large horns, who spoke like a dragon. Revelation 13 verse 11. This beast took on a special role, sharing the first beast's authority and performing miraculous signs, like calling fire down from heaven, reminiscent of the prophet Elijah. Revelation 13 verse 13. The second beast directed all worship toward the image of the Antichrist and marked those who followed with the mark of the beast. Revelation 13 verses 16 to 17. This beast became known as the false prophet. With the unholy trinity now complete, Satan felt poised for victory as more of the elect were deceived. The three evil forces prepared for the final battle, unleashing demonic spirits that looked like frogs to deceive the kings of the earth and gather them for war against God. Revelation 16 verses 13 to 14. The final battle between good and evil was destined to take place at a location known as Armageddon. There, the forces of darkness gathered, ready for the arrival of Satan's ancient foe. Suddenly, a brilliant white light pierced through the sky, and from the clouds, a man on a white horse descended, accompanied by a multitude of riders from heaven's gates. The great King of Kings had returned to earth, but before the battle could begin, an angel standing in the sun called out to the birds of the sky, inviting them to gather for the great supper of God. Revelation 19 verse 17. This proclamation echoed across both armies, igniting the battle. The beast, along with the kings of the earth and their armies, fought against the heavenly army, but the battle was swift and decisive. The beast and the false prophet were captured and thrown alive into the fiery lake of burning sulfur. Revelation 19 verse 20. As they fell, they witnessed the annihilation of Satan's army by God's forces, followed by a swarm of birds feasting on the flesh of the fallen. Revelation 19 verse 21. Defeated, Satan attempted to escape but was seized by an angel and locked away in the abyss for 1,000 years. Revelation 20 verses 1-3. During this time, Jesus reigned on earth in peace, and the believers who had been martyred for the gospel were resurrected to rule with him. Revelation 20 verse 4. For 1,000 years, Satan brooded in the abyss, consumed by bitterness and anger over his repeated defeats at the hands of God. He had always believed that he deserved the glory that humans were given, and he had tried everything to ruin God's redemptive plan for humanity, only to fail each time. Even after forming an unholy trinity to oppose the Godhead, his efforts were futile. When the 1,000 years ended, Satan was released from the abyss and immediately sought to deceive the nations one final time. He succeeded in gathering an army as numerous as the sand on the seashore, surrounding the camp of God's people and the holy city. Revelation 20 verses 7-8. But just as the battle seemed imminent, fire came down from heaven and devoured Satan's army. Revelation 20 verse 9. Enraged, Satan was captured and thrown into the lake of burning sulfur, where he would be tormented forever. Revelation 20 verse 10. As the smoke cleared, Satan caught a final glimpse of humanity, now perfected and glorious, welcomed into heaven by their creator. Screaming in the lake of fire, Satan realized how far he was from the glory that God had bestowed upon mankind through Christ's atoning work.
If you found this video enjoyable, please consider liking and sharing it. Additionally, subscribing to this channel will ensure that you receive more updates in the future. Thank you.